Going our separate ways, political divisiveness. Politically divisive when going your separate ways. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brianne. Well, I thought I would touch upon another topic that's very, very current. You know, there's so much political divisiveness in the world. And I think people have really begun to kind of break apart and take sides. And I believe that it's just something we can deny or we can admit that is happening. But I think we're seeing it in just about every area of life that we know. It can be in families, it could be relatives, it could be in the workplace, it could be at church, it could be in the neighborhood, it could be friendships that have been longstanding or newer friendships, political divisiveness. You know, I understand it because I have my own viewpoints and my own beliefs. And for me personally, I respect that everyone has a difference of opinion. I respect that. Unfortunately, there are some people that don't respect that. And those are the people, for me personally, that I separate from. I don't separate from people who have different opinions. I separate from people who are not nice about it and demand that we think like they think, and or are rude or nasty to other people. So I don't associate with those kinds of people. And so this video is talking about going your separate ways. And you know, there are times in life, it may not just be politics, it could be over any kind of issue, where the relationship has run its course or it needs to be put on hold for the moment and we need to go our separate ways. I believe it's in how we go our separate ways that reflect who we are. I believe that if I'm going to break off a friendship, if I'm going to break off a relationship, if I'm going to break off a work-related relationship, I believe in doing it kindly. I believe in doing it thoughtfully. For me personally, I say, hey, I don't agree with your viewpoints, and I don't agree maybe even with your attitude. And so I feel the need to step back from the relationship at this time. And maybe we can go back into the relationship at another time and rework it. And yet for right now, I'm stepping back. Now, that, as great as that sounds, often the other person will respond in not a nice way. And so I understand that, but it's how I respond that matters, not how they respond. That's their choice. And it's my choice to separate and go my separate way in a kind, thoughtful manner. And there is so much political divisiveness. And remember, what people believe and stand for reflects who they are. So do I want to continue on a close relationship with someone who is completely opposite in my viewpoints? Probably not. It depends. I may have a very light relationship with them. And I actually have relationships with people who are very opposite of me, but because we have been friends for a very, very long time, we have both respect each other's we each have a different viewpoint, and we navigate around it and we talk about other subjects. And so I am able to save some of those relationships, but not all. I've had relationships that no matter how I didn't talk about things, the other person continued to throw it in my face in an angry way. And so I had to back off from those kinds of relationships. So I do believe that sometimes we have to separate and go our separate ways. And I have done it. I am doing it. I am in the process of doing it with some people, not with many, but with some. And so sometimes it's necessary. Sometimes it can be over non-political issues. It can be over any kind of issue that we feel that going forward in a relationship, at least at this time, is not the right thing to do, but to go our separate ways, amicably and politely and kindly. From my house to yours, may God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. Bye-bye.